Last week, we showed you this video of a strange contraption barreling up US 41. At the time, we figured out what it was, a recumbent bike, but not who it belonged to.
Well, tonight, NBC2's Gid Golding introduces us to the man behind that neon yellow mystery.
To find the man behind the bike, I took a ride north. That's where I met Dave Lewis, who owns this snug little machine that turned heads all across Southwest Florida.
It's kind of like being in a rocket.
Honestly, it kind of looks like it too. This rocket is called a Velomobile.
Some people call us Velonauts.
Dave Lewis took off from Key West last Monday and soared all the way to Sarasota County, but not before he was spotted on 41 in Punta Gorda, not just by this driver.
I was pulled over just before Fort Myers. He was just curious. He's like, what is this? I was like, oh, just a Velomobile. I'm heading home.
So why was Dave making the 300 plus mile journey? Well, he just wrapped up an ultra cycle race known as the Florida 500. That's 500 miles from Jacksonville to the Keys.
Yeah, I made it in 22 hours and 21 minutes.
If you're trying to do the math in your head, that's an average of 30 miles per hour, or rocket speed for a bike. All of this at age 58, mind you.
And I was toast. I was so tired.
Michael Rudy took the video that sparked this story. He told me last week that he was worried.
This is like just begging to get hit or run over.
I definitely don't want to get run over.
Hence the neon yellow paint job and reflective tape. Heck, this Velomobile has super bright taillights, headlights, and even a horn.
I think it would be an unusual instance for someone to roll over, to drive over a large neon log.
The Florida Highway Patrol said last week that Dave has the right to use the full lane, but could be cited if he was holding up traffic. That's why he doesn't like to travel on roads like 41.
I will take the lane if there aren't many cars. But if there's cars around, a plentitude of cars, I definitely get over in the lane, at the bike lane, and deal with the debris.
Riding around in his Velomobile, Dave still has many more heads to turn. Hopefully some of those will turn into Velonauts just like him.
It's my dream to see a highway teeming with Velomobiles.
Reporting for NBC2, I'm Gage Golding.
That's pretty.